I'm Gonzalo García from McAllen, Texas, and I play accordion, so.
Bueno, Antonio Tapia.
Un saludo muy fuerte, todos los que me conocen. Un abrazo muy fuerte para todos mis amigos. Un saludo.
Okay, what's your first number?
Vamos a tocar esta bonita polca de Narciso Martínez, el Huracán del Valle, que se llama La Cuquita para todos
La
ustedes.
coquita, all right. ¿En qué tono está el acordeón ese?
Gracias, muchas gracias. Este acordeón, Don Lupe, está en el tono de sol.
Sol,
Do,
you see it.
fa.
Sí. Ok, vámonos. ¿Cómo se llama la canción?
Valía más.
Valía más para todos ustedes.
El Ruco Martínez.
Hoy me pagas con una traición.
Hoy me tomo las copas de vino.
Muy alegre la música de Ruco, ¿eh? ¿Verdad? Un aplauso a You Guys Are Doing Great. Okay.
You guys are witnessing history.
Oh, by the way, those of you that don't know, this stage is built in the form of the house of the late Don Narciso Martinez, who is known as the father of Conjunto.
Ahora vamos a tocarles esta redoba de Don Narciso Martínez, el huracán del Valle, que se llama El Testerazo.
Vámonos.
Resting, but we were so close, and I helped him play for about maybe 12 years, I would say. During those 12 years, I recorded about maybe 12 CDs with him, And there was this one particular melody that I loved because he did like a potpourri. When he put a bunch of little parts of different polkas and get them together and you name them. Well, he did one and he called it, here it goes. Well, anyway, here we go.
Narciso Martín.
Ok, adiós palomita para todos ustedes.
Thank you. Well, mira, I started playing accordion when I was 3 years old. Started with a toy accordion, this. Yeah. But well, that toy accordion. What I tell people is that the toy accordion that I had wasn't like the toy accordions from nowadays. Porque ya las hacen de botones las acordeones yeah, chiquitas. Y esta no, the toy accordion I had, it had some, I believe it was aluminum or something like that. And then, como la parrilla aquí, yeah. Se levantaba la plaquita así.
Yeah.
Se quebraba. Se quebraba, yeah. So, yeah, like so you know, my grandfather from...
Ahí está bueno, mira.
Okay. Let me take the air out of me.
Yeah, press the button, sounds like...
Well, let me put my accordion down so I can.
Okay, go.
But well, like I was saying, you know, that's how I started playing because my grandfather from my mom's side of the family and his brothers, they played. You know, ellos tocaban. Mi abuelo por parte de mi y sus hermanos eran músicos. So, mi abuelo, en esta acordeón tan nuevecita, mira.
Does that have a breathing button? Is it breathing button?
I don't know. I just, we have it here.
The top one.
So then my grandfather would just, me tarareaba las canciones con la boca. Tararara. So yo tenía que sacarla aquí. Okay, what should I play? Let me see what I can, a ver si me acuerdo. Vamos a tocar una. Un guapanguito que se llama Tamaulipas hace 5 años. Oh, no puedo. Bueno, vamos a tocar la porquita de Xatotonilco. And I remember when I was a kid. Well, you know, but and that's how I.
That's how you learn.
I mean, that's how I learn. Digo, ¿qué tal pelado? Porque toco muy poquito. Pero, well, yo no soy nadie, en realidad. Yo soy una persona como ustedes, una persona humilde. And well, yo nomás toco lo que yo sé tocar en realidad.
¿Qué le aconsejas a un estudiante que está comenzando a tocar el acordeón?
A un estudiante, Lupe, pues que...
¿Qué le dirías a un estudiante que está aprendiendo acordeón?
I would tell him to, well, as he, que le eche ganas, you know, que he's got to have a lot of discipline, porque, well, I didn't learn in a day, in a week, you know, okay. So hay que echarle muchas ganas y, pues, seguir. Siempre adelante, nunca dejar el acordeón y pues aprender lo que se pueda. Y no...
Yo cuando tenía 7, 8 años dormía con el acordeón.
Go for it.
Bueno, I'm gonna play this polka que le compuse a mi mujer. Le puse Estela.
Ándale.
Ahí va. En sol mayor.
Thank you.
Tony de la Rosa, ¿no?
Sí.
Gloria
de Tony.
Vamos a tocarles esta bonita polca. Mi compañero don Juan Antonio Tapia y un servidor, Gonzalo García, el pingüino. Esta polquita que se llama La Grulla para todos ustedes. He was a founder and accordionist of Los Norteños de Terán. You know, my grandfather, well, he was born in the town of General Terán, Nuevo León, Hacienda La Florida. And he made his first recording here on the Ideal Records around 1951 with his partner, Baldomero Elizondo Gonzalez. It was a 78 RPM record, and, well, they were just called Los Norteños. On one side was El Corrido de Enrique Oviedo, the Ballad of Enrique Oviedo, which was composed by Mr. José Ramos Saldívar. And on side B there was a ranchera, canción ranchera, Falsa Engañadora, and that was composed by Mr. Pedro Garza. But my grandfather, he started playing the accordion in Reynosa, Tamaulipas, because he was working with somebody there, you know, y el patrón de él le regaló un acordeón. There was a place that sold music instruments, and they also sold records. It was named the Discoteca El Nopal. So what my grandfather says, he said that there were two accordions, a two-row accordion and a three-row accordion. So my grandfather was about 14 years old then, I believe. So he wanted the three-row accordion, one like this. but his boss told him, you know, it's too grande para ti. It's too big for you. You know. Well, my grandfather said, yes, but I want that accordion, you know. So then they gave me, his boss gave him the accordion, and my grandfather said that all the musicians would go see him where he lived to play, because he was the only one who had a three-row accordion back then. But that's how he started, first as Los Norteños and then as Los Norteños de Terán. I actually, I donated my good friend here, Pedro Avila, some pictures of my grandfather, a picture of the original Norteños de Terán, which was him, my grandfather Pablo Silva, Edelmiro Abrego, and Américo Pérez. And then, but I believe they never recorded. So then his second partner was the one who recorded with my grandfather, Baldomero Elizondo.
Mira, aquí tengo un disco que dice, Hay No Más.
Oh, sí.
¿Quiénes son?
Es mi abuelo. Israel o un coyote.
Ok, aquí está el disco, mira, tócalo. Ese es el disco. Oh. Ahora lo van a poner allá en la pianola. No. Para que lo oigas.
¿Me va a tocar?
Ya.
Vamos a oírlo.